This part of the class is heavily reliant upon you understanding how water works within the Earth system, the hydrosphere, in other words. Therefore, we need to do a quick recap and then begin. As you're aware, water comes in three states of matter: solid, liquid, gas, and water can change from a solid to a liquid. When it does that, the scientific process when water goes from a solid to a liquid is called melting. When water goes from a liquid to a gas, the scientific process is known as evaporation. When water goes from a gas to a liquid, that scientific process is called condensation. And when water goes from a liquid to a solid, we call that freezing. That is the actual scientific term for it. As you are also aware, water can go from being a solid to a gas or a gas to a solid, bypassing the liquid state. When it does that, we call this either sublimation or deposition. Mostly this has to do with which direction the water's going. If the water's going from a gas to a solid, for example, frost, we call this deposition because something's being deposited. When it goes from a solid to a gas, we call this sublimation. Although within the scientific community, many times people will use the term sublimation to mean both directions, and I do that as well. Take a look at this diagram. You can see basically it is the states of water. What I want you to pay attention to first is this, though. Up at the top, it says heat taken from the environment. Notice that water is going from a solid to a liquid to a gas. What's happening is the water molecule itself is absorbing energy out of the environment. In most cases, this is probably out of the atmosphere. Because in order for water to go from a solid to a liquid to a gas, what has to happen is the water molecule has to have more energy to switch states. And when it does that, it has to get that energy from someplace. Therefore, it absorbs that energy and holds onto that energy, stores that energy. Then notice along the bottom, you can see that as water goes from a gas to a liquid to a solid, what's happening is heat is released into the environment. What that's telling you is that as water's going from a gas to a liquid to a solid, the water molecule itself is slowing down. As it does that, it loses energy. When it loses energy, it dumps that energy into, in most cases, the atmosphere. This is what drives storms. You can see then that if there is a lot of water in the atmosphere and that water is switching states, going from a vapor to a liquid to ice, even just vapor to liquid, think of a hurricane, the largest storm that happens on this planet. Lots and lots of energy will be dumped into the atmosphere. Those storms then use that energy to drive themselves. The hydrologic cycle is the water cycle. Let's take a look at the hydrologic cycle first. Take a look at the diagram. Examine it. See the terminology on there. Now I'm going to go through the terminology. If you look at the far right-hand side, you can see that there's a body of water. And off of that body of water, evaporation is occurring. So the water's going from a liquid into a gas. Then you can see just up above that arrow, it points to the word condensation, which is a cloud. Clouds are generally made up of condensed water, which means the water has gone from a gas into a liquid. Sometimes it's solid matter also. It just depends on the temperature up there in the sky. But then you have a cloud. Then you can see the cloud moves inland, and when it does, the cloud might very well precipitate. Precipitation is anything that falls out of a cloud. So it doesn't make any difference whether this is rain, sleet, snow, hail. All of these things are forms of precipitation. When that water comes down and hits the ground, it has one of two choices. It can either move across the surface of the planet as runoff. You can see that term right in the middle of that diagram. Or it can soak into the ground through a process called infiltration. So infiltration means that the water is soaking into the ground. When it does that, it becomes groundwater. In Southern California, this is the primary source of water for most people's local well water that's coming from the groundwater that sits underneath us. In addition to that, you can see kind of on the right-hand middle, there's a forest, I guess you could say that's what that's supposed to be. And transpiration is happening. Transpiration is when plants sweat. Human beings perspire, plants transpire. So transpiration is the loss of moisture from plants into the atmosphere. That adds moisture into the atmosphere. It increases the humidity of the atmosphere. You could also see that there's evaporation coming off the bodies of water that are on land. In addition to that, you could see that on tops of the mountains in the background, sublimation is occurring. So the water is going from a solid into a gas. If you look at the entirety here, you notice that it's making a big circle. Hence the name hydrologic cycle. Cycle is the Greek word for circle. You're all aware, of course, that a bicycle has two circles, right? A tricycle, like what most of us started to learn how to ride on, has three circles. Strange people sometimes in the park near my house will ride through the park on a unicycle. A unicycle has one circle. So there you go. The hydrologic cycle is just telling you that water is constantly changing states within the Earth's system.